Hi friends! Well, thank you and welcome to my channel once again. Thank you for those of you that have already subscribed to my channel. And please, I want to thank you for the first video I did. Actually got so many people complimented me for that. Thank you so much. So I said, okay, I need to be doing more videos for us. So that's how I'm here again. And please, if you don't subscribe to the channel, just press the red button. What are you waiting for? Thank you so much. So, I've started something the last time, and I think there are some things I need to put on that video because it's my first video, so I just did it very brief. So I need to talk about a few things now first before I jump into today's video. I'm still going to do this on this video, don't worry. So is please, if those tips I gave actually worked for me, and what I want to talk about here is please eat your dinner on time before you go to bed. You have to eat your dinner on time. You can eat it 3 hours, 4 hours, depends on you, before you go to bed. Don't just eat and go to bed. If you do that, it will actually give your tummy, in fact, that food will not even digest, you know? You're just, if you wake up in the morning at times, if I do that these days, I have to understand my body. So if I do that, what happens to me is that I actually get bloated the next day, or my tummy will look as if I am 3 or 4 months pregnant. You know, that's why we have to reduce our carbs. And please, maybe for dinner, we should try and, I would say, for example, it doesn't actually mean your food that you actually eat in dinner, if you actually that's why you have to discipline yourself to discipline yourself and take little portion of that food that you're eating. You have to let portion control come in here. It doesn't matter the kind of food, you know. Some of us actually go for carbs like pounded yam, rice, spaghetti. Some of us actually eat them dinner. If you want to even eat them at dinner, try and reduce them. You know, try and reduce them so you can get the best result. Put yourself on a calorie deficit. Put yourself in a challenge. Tell yourself, now in 3 days, I want to try and be eating early before I go to bed. Or now till 1 month, I want to put myself on this challenge. Or you know what you know that will be good for you. Just try and do it. That is how you can get the result you're actually looking for. Because if you don't challenge yourself, you don't put yourself under control, if you cannot control this flesh, you know, this flesh is actually our worst enemy. And when it comes to dinner, this flesh can, when you're sleeping, you wake up by 10, oh God, I'm still hungry. And please go to bed early. Once you finish your dinner, you relax, maybe you watch telly, two or three news, just 3 hours to go to bed. Don't stay, except you've disciplined yourself not to eat. If you want to eat, for example, by 9 or 8, I would advise you to actually go for eat your dinner by 8. Depends on the nature of your job, because some of us comes home 9, we are still 9. That's when you're back before you prepare the meal. I understand, but just try. You just need to try. You just need to give it a try. You just have to tell yourself, because if you don't discipline yourself this way, you're not going to see the results you're looking for. You're not going to, that tummy don't, it will not reduce. You just need to, and the exercise actually, eating healthy is not about for you to be slimmer. It's for your health being. It's not for you to be slimmer, for you to be filled. No, it's all about your health. This is what we're talking about here. Now that sometimes people actually ask me or tell me to stop exercise, I'm not doing it for me to reduce. It's actually for my health. I'm talking about my health here. So that is why it's good. So you should try and go to bed early. You have to go to bed early. I understand most of us. I understand the, if you can discipline yourself, no problem. You know, you can discipline yourself. There's no problem about that. Go ahead. But if you cannot, go to bed on time. Please go to bed on time. That is one for one. And secondly, I want to talk about something that is still important, and the way we spicy our food. This is the two things I'll be using: garlic and ginger. Please, garlic and ginger are very important. Please, we try and include them to steaming our meats is very important. You see, garlic and ginger. I can't emphasize on those things enough. If you want to use the raw one or the one you can get at the supermarket, go and get them. Add them to your. Actually add ginger to my smoothie. It's very good. Ginger is very good in losing weight, especially our tummy. Ginger is very important. It's very good. I am not telling you lie. I have been using ginger for the past 3 years. Raw one. I'm not talking about the one you buy at the supermarket. The bottle one or the raw one. Please, will you try and invest those two things, ginger and garlic? Forget about the smell. If the smell will make you look good, forget about the smell. Just know the way you're adding them to your meal. Forget about the smell. I'm not telling us to add it to our soup, but when we are steaming our meat, we should try and include ginger and garlic. And most of us want to reduce belly fat. Try and be taking ginger. Ginger is good. You can do detox on ginger. Just grate your ginger, lemon, cucumber, and scent. Is this mint leaf? Add them together. Let them just put them in night before. Maybe you pass. Just put them in night before. The next morning, drink it. It's good for detox. Very good for detox. So ginger is very, very good. Most of us want to lose tummy fat. Be applying them to your meal. Use it to steam your meats. It's very important. This is what I said I want to comment today and talk about. And please, I'll be doing my video every Monday because for now, I don't know the time and when I'll be uploading video. But I think for now, I will be uploading video every Monday. That'll be okay for me. And I think I wanted to be doing it 2 times in the week, but if I can, I still have good news to tell you guys. I see what I There are still things I need to tell you for us to do. All of us, we are the one doing it. This channel is not just for me. Please, you can write on the comment section what you want me to talk about. You can write it there. I'll talk about it if I know the thing. If you have something to say, I'm not only the person that will be talking. You can still go to the comment section and write your own view on what you know, so we all can learn from this whole thing I'm talking about. Healthy lifestyle is the best. Yes, I'm telling you, it's just the best. You cannot, in fact, I cannot overemphasize on this. It's the best. It's the best. It makes you feel good on the inside, not just on the outside. It makes you feel good on the inside. Please. Please, let's try and embrace 2019. This year, let's try and push ourselves. Ladies, please. Brothers, should I use our brother, our sisters? Oh, I don't know what to say now. Let's try and embrace a healthy lifestyle. It doesn't matter the amount of workout you went out to do. It doesn't matter if there's no gym close to you, no problem. Just go out, walk. Walking is good, as I said in my first video. 2019 is our year to tackle those places that we actually need changes. You cannot be procrastinating. This year is our year, so we should all do something. This year is our year, so we should all stand up. Try. Healthy dream might not be weight loss, might be something else. I made up my mind that this year, all that God has for me, I'm going to go there and get them. I don't need to wait. You need to go there and get them. So this is the year. This year we are marching forward in our health aspect, in everything we are marching. So I want to use opportunity to thank you once again. Thank you so much. Until I see you in my next video.